Focused on certain sorts of things like trash pickup. Those who live in the country have, I don't know, you guys probably know, have different needs, so we might just be polarized because we have different needs. We might also be polarized because we have different evidence about questions. So let's say we care a lot about tax policy. Well, maybe I know a lot about some area of tax policy and you know a lot about some other area of tax policy. And because we have different evidence about the tax policy situation, we might disagree about what the most effective tax policy is. A last option you might think is we might just disagree. So we might have all the same information about tax policy. We might know all the facts about fetuses and what's going on in their cells. And we might just disagree about whether or not abortion is permissible or whether or not this is the most effective tax policy, even if we have the same evidence. Okay, so the standard view among social psychologists who look at this sort of thing is that kind of belief polarization, the last kind, is irrational. So what do they mean by that? So belief polarization, the way that social psychologists talk about it, is increased disagreement after seeing the same evidence. So if you have two people and they see the same thing and then their beliefs get further apart, that's belief polarization. So why is that supposedly irrational? Well, the really natural thing to think is this, uniqueness. So philosophers have talked a lot about this thesis. Uniqueness. Uniqueness says, given some set of evidence, there's only one right thing to believe in light of that evidence. So it doesn't necessarily have to be a belief. Sometimes evidence, you should just suspend belief about the question given some evidence. But it can't be the case that it's rational to believe that grass is green in light of the evidence, but also rational to believe that grass is purple in light of the evidence. That's not. Okay. So if you buy that, then that belief polarization is irrational should seem right to you. If we share our evidence, then we should be getting closer together in what we believe. So if we're doing this irrational thing, what causes it? Well, social psychologists have had a lot to say about this. So there's a bunch of different views in the literature. Probably the most well-known one is this view from Lord et al. So Lord et al. Think that there's two bad things going on. There's biased evaluation and biased assimilation of evidence. So what I take the evidence to be supporting, I evaluate the evidence based on what I already believe, so I take it to be more likely to support my view, whatever that is. And then whether or not I take on board that evidence, actually let it affect my belief, is also a function of what I believe. So Lord et al. Actually think that biased evaluation is fine, and they give a defense of that, and they think that biased assimilation is bad. But either way, they think there's something irrational there. There's lots of other theories of what could create belief polarization. So maybe it's motivated reasoning, I just really want to be someone who's pro-choice. philosophy on the model of science. These folks and I are in a lab group together, and we do this together. So here it goes. All right. So if we're doing science, we want to understand complex phenomena. What do we do? Most of you are scientists, so I take it that this will come naturally to you. So we have the San Francisco Bay, and we're trying to decide whether or not the plan to dam the bay is going to be a good plan or not. So something we could do is we build the San Francisco Bay model, and we run some tests. We use other kinds of models. You know, we teach undergraduates predator-prey models, Luckebolt-Terre equations. One kind of model that is common to see is agent-based models. So what's going on with agent-based models? So agent-based models have these features. Some things that are going on in agent-based models, there's usually simple agents, so really simple objects. And those simple objects interact in simple ways. And then what comes from them?
Thank you. Thank you.
Before anybody says a random thing, everybody's going to get a reason from the outside. Just a random new reason. And that's going to repeat. So what's going to happen here is everybody's going to get a new reason from the outside world. One random person's going to say one random thing. Everybody's going to hear the reason that they said and adjust their belief. And they're going to forget if necessary. And then repeat. Everybody gets a new reason from the outside world. Someone says a random thing.
インクのエプソンの 73L を探してみます。これいくらやるんですか？ Ay, sí. そこに出てたんで、あるかな。
だから税抜き2120円
でございます。あ、じゃあ、
はい。じゃあそのままレジを持ちます。はい。